is no wonder an overwhelming 8 in 10 Americans feel the economy is heading in the wrong direction. The
biggest burden that's weighing negatively on household sentiment is inflation.
The dance, the dog, the pony show, all these different things. Yellen was there with the president yesterday trying to say that your wallet is lying to you, in addition to the actual textbook definition of what a recession is. These people that are not serious actors on this planet. And again, what's so unfortunate about it is they're playing these games, is it's not like semantics is harmless here. Again, what bothers me most is that the average person is 4% worse off today than a year ago. Actually, even worse than the net sum of the negative economic growth. And yet, these people, out of their own political interest, have the audacity to say, no, it's not a recession. It is sickening. Joining us now, Congresswoman Maria Elvira Salazar. Maria, it is just so frustrating, isn't it, when politics trumps the well-being of, I don't know, us?
Of course. And thank you very much for giving me the opportunity. I agree with you. I'm here in Congress right now. I'm outside the floor where we have a lot of votes today. And I thank you very much for the opportunity. I've been here for 18 months. And I haven't done anything in order to help the average American. It doesn't matter the political party, Democrat, Republican, Independent. Right now, if you go to the supermarket, 1 out of 4 Americans cannot buy everything they need because of they don't have the money. 1 out of 2, when they go to the gas pump, they cannot fill the tank because it's too much money per gallon. So that is miserable. 4 years ago, we were in a much better position. And the reason why I came to Congress is to try to help not only the Americans, but District 27. We haven't done it. Why? Because Nancy Pelosi is in charge of the House of Representatives, and they have not brought one bill that will lower, not forget about inflation, affordability. You cannot afford what you need. Gas, eggs, buying uniforms for your children, finding people to work in your shop. And what have we done? Well, the Democrats only want to spend more money and tax corporations. And that's, and you know, to be more specific, and I know that I can speak until tomorrow. We voted yesterday on this CHIPS. This is, let me just explain, if you allow me, what the Democrats voted on, because I voted against.
Yeah, I'm interested $280
billion. Very easy. Look, this is a $280 billion bill. That supposedly what it does is that it brings the big boys back to the United States to build the semiconductors, which we know that are extremely important to society. We have semiconductors in cars and phones and defense and the rockets. Everything needs a semiconductor, the phones that we're talking on. And now we want the American boys to come back to build and those semiconductors in the United States. Yeah, okay, that's a good idea. We're going to give you $80 billion, but unfortunately, that bill that came from the Senate does not tell you that there are massive loopholes in this bill that allows companies to take the taxpayer money, the $280 billion, and still build chips in China. Oh, no. If I want you to come, you got to stay here. You cannot go back and build it over there with my money. Number
Amen.
Two, yeah, you don't have to be a United States company to accept this money. Oh, no. What do you mean? So you can be from any other country except Americans? Oh, yeah. Then we're going to give you part of the $280 billion. All right, number three, you don't even have to build the new facilities in the United States. What do you mean? I'm giving you the money to come and build new factories to build the semiconductors in the United States. Oh, no, that's not on the bill. That's why Marco Rubio and Rick Scott voted against it, and I did too. You see, these are the things that I just don't understand how come the Dems are doing it, because they want to benefit whomever.
Well,
they don't want to benefit the guy who's listening to you.
And to that end, Congresswoman, yeah, Nancy Pelosi's husband, who leading up to this invests $5 million in semiconductor companies, Pelosi thinks we're all that much more ignorant than she already apparently assigned to us, saying that he never had information from her about what was happening here. Right. A random blind $5 million bet he
sure.
made with that kind of timing. And to your point as well about some of the maneuvering with these foreign companies as well, to where often members of Congress have interests that aren't even the American interest, but whatever their own financial interest happens to be.
Correct. And you know that they are not in the business of praying, these American companies, and they are going to go whatever their stock share, their stock, or their stocks go higher, and they have the biggest profit margin. And I understand, but not with my taxpayers' money, with your money. And so they come to the government and they say, please, we need some Fed help because, you know, we have been in China all these years and we need to come back home. Okay, I'm going to help you to come back home, but you have to stay home and benefit the people that live at home. That's it. It's easy. So going back to the economy, I repeat, it doesn't matter what political party you're in. When you go to the gas station, the gas pump doesn't ask you, what political party do you belong to? No, it's just that you have to pay a lot more for that, to fill that tank. And that's why we're trying to bring some sense. I think that unfortunately the Democratic Party has lost completely its way. This thing that is not only the economy, is the gender ideology, is defunding the police, is thinking that democratic socialism is good, is that trying to talk to our kids in first grade or in kindergarten about their gender tendencies or orientations. I think that these people are just, they lost their way. And let's thank God for the American electoral system that in November is going to give the voters another chance to determine who do they want to be in charge. And if they put us in charge, humble Maria in District 27 will definitely vote American values, not American political parties.
You just reminded me of something else that's on my radar. I'm going to be bringing up after 11:05 what happened in the Miami-Dade School District last night involving education material pertaining to transgenderism and all kinds of other things. So anyway, there are many moving pieces, including with elements right here, which is another thing, is we've seen so much of what's happened nationally exported locally to where the agenda has been driven from on high towards a lot of radicalism. Which is a whole other problem.
Yeah,
wokeism.
That's not the American way. That's not the American way. I don't know what happened last night, but I'm going to inform myself. I think I'm going to be here the whole. We're going to be voting on a lot of very interesting issues. August recess starts, so I'll be in the district the whole month of August talking to constituents. Would love to be back on your show whenever you want me. Yeah, I'm here to serve others.
Sounds good. Yeah, and the Reader's Digest on it is they approved a book that, in theory, did not meet state law, that includes gender identity, sexual orientation, and abortion education for grade school children, called Comprehensive Health Skills. But instead, they approved a version they said is going to be redacted, that will be quote-unquote age-appropriate to try to comply with state law. So the devil's going to be in the details there, I think.
Of course, you don't need to be talking to a child that is in kindergarten about anything that is related to sexual topics. Let him develop, and then after that, he can determine whatever thing he wants to be. And if he wants to be trans, fine, that's his choice. But don't influence young children or young minds one way or the other. Let them be.
Congresswoman, as we've learned, the brain isn't even fully developed until 25. And how many of us had all the answers when we were teenagers? So it doesn't need to be taught even at those kind of ages either, because permanent solutions to temporary considerations at that age, no doubt. Congresswoman Maria Elvira Salazar, pleasure talking with you.
Always wonderful. And you have a great weekend, and God blesses us. We need help from above. My love to you, Brian. Bye-bye.
Amen. God bless you, and God bless all of us for sure. All right. Mayhem. Biden and recession, the theme of my top three takeaways next here on the Brian Mudd Show, News Radio 610 WIOD.